Have you ever lost important data due to hardware or software issue? Well, if yes, you came into the right video. From accidental formatting or system malfunction, having a recovery software can save you a lot of time, especially if you need those files for work, school, or business transactions. So what is data recovery? For starters, data recovery is a process of retrieving data that has been lost, deleted, corrupted, or made inaccessible due to various reasons. It is important because data is often valuable and irreplaceable for individuals and organizations. Data loss can cause financial losses, legal issues, emotional distress, or reputational damages. Some common data loss scenarios are, first is accidental deletion or formatting of files or storage devices. Next is hardware failures such as disk crashes, power surges, or physical damages. Third is software errors such as bugs, viruses, malware, or ransomware. Fourth is natural disasters such as fire, flood, earthquake, or lightning. And fifth, human errors such as mishandling, theft, or sabotage. Data recovery software varies in file format support, and choosing a right program that can cater for your specific file type can take time, especially with numerous programs available on the web. Luckily, with AnyRecover, you can recover almost 1,000 plus file types, whether from an important email or to an important document that your boss has sent to you. You can also recover your data from external devices such as SD cards, thumb drive, digital camera, and even the lost partition from crashed computers. It can also support YouTubers and TikTokers to repair corrupted videos. In this video, I'll demonstrate on how you can use this program whether recovering a file from your hard drive or external drives. For this video, I'm going to use a Windows PC, but this program will also works well with Mac OS devices. So without further ado, let's start. The program links for this program are available in the description. Once you're in the site, click the free download option and a set of files will be downloaded. Then proceed to program installation. Just click the downloaded file and follow the prompts to show on your screen. Hit yes. Then select the install icon and the program will start into full installation. Now we're here into the program's main dashboard. Here you'll see all of your connected devices. Here I have 3 connected storages. For this, we will try to recover videos with different file sizes. Before we operate this, let's go to File Explorer and I will show sample of my video files before deleting them and formatting the SD card. Here are 2 videos which are inside of the SD card. Now we will delete the videos and format the drive. Inside the AnyRecover program, we will go to specific drive where the videos are deleted. Take note that you'll need to purchase to unlock all of the features of this program. However, for this free version, you'll be able to scan and preview unlimitedly as well as free recovery for 100 megabytes. In addition, you can unlock additional 100 megabytes of file recovery if you will share a link of the software through mailing or sharing the links through any platforms, making it to 200 megabytes. This can be done by selecting the share icon on the upper portion of the dashboard and posting them on your socials. For file recoveries higher than 200 megabytes, you'll need to purchase the program. The prices varies for the amount of computers that you will use and the time period of the subscription. Once you selected the drive that you want your files to be recovered, the program will first do a quick scan of the drive. It will then proceed into deep scan, wherein this scan may take a long time depending on the storage size. Even if you see your file already, it is still advised to complete the scan because the data of the file could be incomplete. Once the deep scan is complete, there could be a change in file name, but the goal here is to recover the file in its form. We can see here that there's a lot of videos present, and this might be the same scenario with you. You can manually check one of them if you don't know the file size of the file. To recover the file, just select the recover button that can be seen in the preview section or in the main dashboard. Before recovering, you can preview the file. This will mostly work on smaller size videos. Once you selected the recover button, it will ask you to specify in which you will store the recovered files. It is advisable to put the recovered files into different storage paths, specifically to your desktop if you're using external storage device. I was able to find my videos and now we will proceed into saving them. Here, after a few minutes, I was able to recover the 2 videos that I've shown in the first part. I hope this video was able to help you. For more information about EnRecover and their other products as well, you can check the description of this video. So this is me again, JC. Thank you and see you in my next video. Bye!